in the quarterfinals at stake here at this $500,000 WTT Champions event, one of the biggest stops in world table tennis. And as I say, what better place to begin round of 16 day than with the top seed in the women's draw, Chen Meng, who will receive first here to Margarita Pasotska.
One love.
Guy McCree to take you through this one on the Infinity Arena, where anything is possible. See what Pasotska can do here. It's a big step up, of course. One of the toughest challenges in the sport.
Love two.
Chen might not be at number one this week, but she remains one of the most difficult challenges.
One, two.
Cameras, of course, social media coverage give you an early sight for that at WTT on the Instagram and Facebook, at WTT Global on the Twitter. A lot of focus, of course, on Chen Meng, particularly after her round of 32 win. She's been putting a lot of time in the training hall, honing her game, trying to get that sharpness back. Good push there, able to follow up. Of course, naturally, it's not just the time in the training hall. They're continuing to rehab that shoulder, making sure that she's in top shape.
3-4.
Just enough change of direction there to take the point.
5-3.
Good start this from Pasotska. Pushing towards the middle, as it turned out, of Chen. Got the error.
Six.
Another error
three.
From the Chinese.
Four, six.
That's more like it.
Let 4-6.
Middle of Pasotska, towards that pocket area from Chen Meng. Better placement this time. Similarities here at the moment for Chen Meng to how she started a round 32 match. Not quite totally at it yet. Uncharacteristic mistakes.
Seven all.
See, they're despite winning that point, emerging more of herself here. She hasn't quite totally found her timing yet. Locked, of course, and numbers are very good for both in this opening game.
7-0.
She's seen quite a few matches in the conditions here on the Infinity Arena where service hasn't played such a key role.
eight,
that's a good change
seven.
Up as well there, going hard, middle and long. Scuttling that serve deep. It's trailed for a lot of this game, Chen Meng, lead of one now.
8-0.
It's the right play for Pysotska. He's been steady so far, seen the errors from Chen Meng, surely will think that can't continue over the course of the match. So it's kind of suggesting at the outset the challenge is on her to bring more. And she did do it there in that point. No, she didn't win it, but I'd say that's an encouraging point. In a sense, that's the way she's got to play. If she's going to go down here, at least try and take the attack to Chen Meng. That's what she tried to do the last couple of points, but has lost both of them, gives Chen a couple of game points.
10-9.
Not happy with the state of the ball there, wants another one. Again, not the sort of third ball you'd expect from the top seed. Sotsky again going obviously from the backhand service her way. Good receive in from Chen Meng, following it up. Third game point. 11-0. Nicely done. So you can see Chen's attack here. The idea is to go to the Pysotska forehand. We've seen it work a couple of times. But not there. Big trouble for Pysotska, though. Just difficult to envisage her winning those sorts of rallies on a consistent basis. She wants to get involved in those. Even Chen here, searching for her best form, is likely to win the majority of those exchanges.
12-0.
Again, an uncharacteristic error. Lifting there on the forehand. Marlin makes of this. It's difficult. Of course, the Infinity Arena, playing with a different ball this week as well. And of course, continuing the comeback from that shoulder problem.
13-12.
Solomia, but a taker. Well, no, this is a big opportunity for Pysotska. You look at the best of five, always say that first game, massive against members of the Chinese national team. Try and put them under some pressure.
13-0.
And she's still in this. Another game point spurned by Chen Meng. She's had, is it four game points, Chen Meng? Few deep breaths here. She now faces a game point against her.
14-0.
Brilliantly done.
15-14.
Continuing to target as much as she can, going to the Posotska forehand. Fifth opportunity here for Chen to close the opener. This time, the error from Posotska, who had a chance. Chen Meng not firing on full capacity yet.
Second game, Chen to serve, love all.
Coaches have had their chances for a word. That drawn out opening game. Foul service here to begin the second from Chen Meng. So much focus on her, of course. She's one of the true stars of this sport of world table tennis. Mentioned earlier how our digital teams have been following her after a round of 32 win. Doing such a great job, our social and digital teams as well, in terms of the action from the training hall. Of course, our focus is here on the Infinity Arena, but as we always say, the hard work is done on the training hall.
1-2.
Chen Meng has always been one of the hardest workers. He's been trying, I think, working even harder, as much as the shoulder, the rehab from the shoulder is allowing her, of course, to try and work herself back towards her best form.
3-1.
Brateko, very good. Brateko in there, and she was a very, very good youth player actually for Ukraine. Won the European Youth Championship 2 years ago, 2018. Gives away an experience, of course, they all do to Marlin. In the round of 32, the runner-up from the star contender, world championship runner-up, beat him.
2-5.
Bretas, really intriguing next match after this, playing Yukiya Uda for the first time. Japanese star. Wonder how long they'll have to wait now with Chun here. Opening up a 3-point lead in the second.
5-3.
Position again here in this second game.
Yeah. 7-5.
Steady. Relatively close to the table there as well, Posotska. It's important she won that point into the towel break as well. Keep in touch, two behind now.
7-5.
Eight. tried to throw that in. Well, a couple of times so far, but started this second game with a foul serve, Chen Meng, the one there. That's why it's important. Pasotska there got it to 5-7 on that point, just kept her in touch, put a little bit more pressure on Chen's couple of services. I think you saw it there. Got to keep these belief levels up. A lot of times European players against the members of the Chinese national team just think sometimes maybe perhaps a little bit too respectful of their achievements. Still got to believe, of course, any sport that you can win and you go out there. Of course they do think that, but it's in the big moments. Do you really believe? Go back to that first game. She had a game point, of course, saved a lot of them, ends up losing it. Big point here. Oh, well, she did brilliantly to keep it alive. Pasotska's showing a lot of what she does well, actually. Couldn't ever really counter. This might slip away from Pasotska again. Just from her perspective, just would like a bit more on that receive, a bit more conviction. Two game points here, Chen Meng.
9-10.
Chen Meng. Second game.
Third game, Pasotska to serve Lovell.
It's a good start to a game from Pasotska. Just a question of whether she can build on it. She's made good starts, actually, across this match.
Love, three.
They're from Ukraine.
Left, love, three.
Commented about both of them how they started the opening game of the match with very high numbers, around 65-70% of points won on serve. Both dropping now, the receive becoming more influential. Pasotska's numbers have really fallen.
3-2.
Chen, in general, cutting out the receive errors from the opening game, and Pasotska here is solid but not able to really dictate behind the service, not able to win points as easily.
Gets one
there as Chen missed times, but that's why the numbers have dropped. It's just tougher for her behind the service to win those points easily.
Oh. 4.
Lock and load, plenty of time there for Chun. Let's take that point.
Four all. Five, four.
Four, six. Okay, let's find a way through there. Just playing kind of slow pace there. Slow spin, not
that
much spin, but
four,
enough.
Six.
It's really the pace of Posotsky here that seems to be troubling Chen Meng.
Five, six.
And I say troubling, of course. Going back on that previous point, a few occasions where Chun has just mistimed. So talk about this table as well. Some of the players have said that. All not coming through sometimes, checking.
Seven,
Sotska's
five.
Tricky, as we know. Again here, Posotsky gets herself to the timeout's call, but Abreteko. Here now, Chun has the service, looking to close in on victory.
Left, 7-0.
Just wonder how much that shoulder injury is rehab from that, still troubling Chen Meng here.
7-8.
Quite a chunk of this match now, nature of the opening couple of games, this one, to have a look at this. Not just a case of, okay, a few points in, right, another match back from the shoulder problem. Actually, quite a body of work now to go into with what Chen Meng's done here.
And
just see some grimaces as well, these shrugs. She's not, of course, one of the most technically sound players out there. Has been upright a few times, some of these mistakes. He's staying on top of the ball through it there. Still managing the injury. Three game points for Posotska.
11,
there we go. Got to say, she's been in all three games so far.
Fourth game, Chen to serve, Lovell.
Chen Meng taken into a fourth game here by Margarita Posotska.
Love all. One love.
It's not where she would have wanted to be here, considering that she was a few points away. Talk about the shoulder problem. Ma Lin, I'm sure this was not part of the script here to go into a fourth game, possibility of more.
Left. One love.
Posotska is an experienced top player. Don't just presume you're going to walk 3-0 through these matches, not at these top events.
Five,
Having been at 7-all with the service, Chen Meng, in that third, normally you'd suggest he uses that as the platform to go on 3-0. That hasn't happened here.
One, two.
Just grimacing a few times, that just wonder with the shoulder. He's having to play at least another game here now as well, staying out there. Sometimes it's good for players, of course, spend more time at the match table.
3-1.
Chen Meng would have preferred trying to close that out in three, but has to forget about all of that now. Refocus as she looks to be doing here. Trying to take this in four.
Nice.
That's where she's done well in the matchup. She's wants to open up the angle of attack here. Posotska stretching wide on the forehand. Oh,
four.
Caught the a bit of tape on the way through. Another look. Really sure there was anything wrong with that. It's just a good angle. Same here as well for Posotska, this chance. She's still got an opportunity here. I mean, she can play, talk about what she does well. She contains opponents at her best. We've seen it in her long career. She could still be a very tricky opponent for Chen Meng at this stage. Chen here trying to step it up, trying to play looser, because at the end of the third game, something I've not mentioned, but just felt she was getting a little bit tight as well because of the match situation. And that's why if Posotska can find a way of getting this, making this closer again, she'd have a chance. Not the case at the moment.
Left
6-2. 7-2. Posotska would have liked a bit more of herself in this fourth. Not really been a factor in it.
2-8.
Would have looked to drive herself on, do a little bit more. If Chen Meng a bit nervous, not maybe totally 100% fit as of yet. Shoulder problem. There's the run that Chen's putting together here, which looks to be taking her to the win.
2-9.
Receive up the middle, and now 8 match points for the top seed.
10-3.
Chen Meng moves through to the quarterfinals here at this WTT Champions European Summer Series. Still working her way to her best form, but that's therefore a much needed win for her.